I'm Jacqueline Miller. I live over on Keith. I'm here today because I'm currently in a case involving a stalker that has included multiple burglaries and potential for violence escalation. This whole entire case has been kind of not fumbled because I don't really put it on the law enforcement, but there's been significant delays where there's weeks go by and I haven't heard. I've sent emails and texts and everything to the detective, and there has been no communication. When there has been a communication with them, it's, and this is including the officer that was responding to all these problems, the detective that's assigned to the case, as well as the detective sergeant. So this is, I've climbed the ladder as much as I can, and now I'm here today. I get told the same thing over and over again, which is a lack of resources and lack of manning. They've explained that the city's growth, which I think everybody can acknowledge has been exponential over the last few years, and I think I've even kind of compared the figures between the city site and it's a growth rate that even the 2040 or 2030 estimation is underestimated. And I know that they had explained that they had asked the city for 2 patrol officers and were granted 1. This delay, including the lack of vehicles, limited manning of detectives, and limited manning of patrol officers, I feel like has directly impacted me as a citizen, but also everyone in the city, because they've also explained that this is the most violent crimes that they've ever had to deal with in Sun Prairie. So these violent crimes are taking precedence over my case because there's technically no like imminent violence, but that doesn't mean that potential isn't right around the corner. So I don't feel safe living here. And it's only a matter of time before that continues to spread. With our growth comes crime, and we're seeing that already. I just feel like the lack of resources that they have is preventing them from getting their job done and protecting us as citizens. So I know that the future and the vision of Sun Prairie focuses heavily on the schools and education and keeping this sense of community and this small city, but great place to live. And I just fear that without giving our law enforcement proper resources, that we are going to end up tarnishing that theme and those values and becoming more of a violent place, and there's not going to be a way to come back from that.
So Jacqueline and I talked before our meeting started this evening, and depending on how long our meeting goes, she and I are going to talk after this meeting. Otherwise, she's got my contact information and will contact me. And the police chief is in the back of the room. He's hearing what you have to say. So we'll follow up with you, Jacqueline.
I have one more thing to tell her.
Sure.
We are actually next Monday at the North Theater, mm-hmm. the Sun Prairie YMCA. We are having a neighborhood meeting where our police chief will be there to talk about the crime and what to do.
Sure.
So, and that's going to be at 6. Isn't that terrible?
I'm not looking at it now. I have my mind on 7.
I believe it's 6:30, but I just want to make sure. Just wait.
6:30,
yes. Thank you.
I want to make sure that everybody knows that I don't in any way sense or in any way word am putting this on the officers involved. I don't believe for a second that they're not putting in everything that they have to it, but I know what it's like. I'm in the military, so I know what it's like to have your hands tied with undermanning.
Yes.
And I empathize with them with that. So.
Okay. I understood that to be your concern, not a criticism of the department.
Absolutely.
But of the resources that the department is giving.
100%.
So we can talk about that. So it is 6:30, Maureen?
Yes, 6:30.
At the YMCA next Monday?
Next Monday, the 27th.
That'd be a good one. She and he are your city council representatives, Maureen Crombie and...
And the business person.
Mike Jacobs, yeah. We've got...
And Jacobs will be.
Councilmember that wishes to speak.
So, very few citizens take the time to come and talk to us. So I want to thank you for taking the time and being very thoughtful and rational in your proposal and being thoughtful and considerate of the officers. I agree with you, we need to do more to help youth not go into crime. That's part of our plan, of course. And it's only a question of when we add more officers as we add another 10,000 people to the city. But I really thank you for taking the time to come in.
Yeah, absolutely. I looked at the comprehensive plan that we have for Sun Prairie, the city has put together. I didn't see anything in there, and I understand that that's not necessarily something that you want to be like, well, we're expecting crime to rise, so we're also going to add police officers. You know, that's not necessarily the focal point of a great city, but at the same time, it's also realistic.
So thank you for your service and what you rank.
I'm a senior airman in the Air Force Guard.
Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely.
Good. Thank you, Jacqueline. We will talk either this evening or...